Hi, welcome to another episode of Techie DIY. I'm Nigel, and in today's video, I'm going to be making an LED mirror sign. The sign consists of a glass mirror that I've engraved and then edge lit with a colour LED strip, and the frame is made out of reclaimed wood. But before we get started with the construction, let's have a quick look at how edge lighting works. An edge light is made from a transparent sheet with a light source located on one or more edges. Light travels through the sheet without escaping because of refraction. Refraction is the way that light bends when it passes from one medium to another. If the light strikes the inner surface at greater than the critical angle, then it will be fully reflected and bounce between the inner surfaces of the glass, which is known as total internal reflection. When the light reaches an edge or an engraved area of the sheet, then the angle is less than the critical angle and the light escapes. So now that we know how edge lighting works, let's have a look at some of the parts used in the project. Firstly, we have a glass mirror tile from IKEA. These come in packs of four, and the tiles measure approximately 11¾ inches or 30 centimeters square. For the lighting, I've used a 1 foot or 30 centimeter length of WS2812 RGB LED light strip. This is programmable and you can individually set each LED color. The strip is available on reels and you can cut them to length at the marked positions. To operate the light strip, we need a controller, and I've used one of these small units, which comes with a remote control. The WS2812 LED strip operates on 5 volts, and it's important to get the right type of controller, as there are also 12 volt versions available. The power supply is 5 volts, and finally the mirror is mounted on a frame made from recycled wood. To create the snowman image, I used my graphics tablet along with paint.net, and the image is available to download from a link in the video description. And that brings me onto the sponsor of the video today, which is Storyblocks. Now, Storyblocks is where you can get all the stock images that you can imagine, including high quality photos, illustrations, and vectors, which includes lots of different icons. My personal favorite is the curated collections, which is a great place to browse and search for inspiration. Storyblocks have a member library of over 400,000 images that you can download and use royalty free in your projects, for both personal and commercial purposes. The account comes with a personalized royalty-free license agreement so that you don't have to worry about copyright, and you can also save 60% on marketplace content. Storyblocks has a search facility to make it easy to find what you're looking for, and believe me, the choice is huge. Click on the link in the description below to start downloading and get started today. Back to the project, and I printed out the image, removed the protective backing from the mirror, centered the image, taped along one edge, and then using water-soluble glue, I stuck it to the back. I then engraved the mirror through the paper. The paper helps prevent the engraver moving around. The engraver that I'm using is a Dremel 290, which has a reciprocating action. In other words, it vibrates rather than rotates, and that means that I can use a ruler to engrave straight lines. The frame for the mirror is made in two sections that are glued together. The front section is made from some old framing timber with a rabbet or rebate cut along one edge in which to locate the mirror tile. And then a second section is made out of pallet wood to increase the depth of the frame. I started making the front section by cutting the framing timber into four lengths, and then cut a 45 degree angle on one of the pieces. I set the fence on the router table to cut approximately 6.5 millimeters or 1/4 inch, and routed rabbets into all four pieces of wood down to a depth of 9.5 millimeters or 3/8 inch. The piece of wood that was cut to 45 degrees is where the LED strip is going to be located, and to accommodate it, I'm going to route an additional groove or slot. And the reason for this is so that the edge of the mirror can sit directly on top of the LEDs rather than to one side. So I changed the router bit to a 3 millimeter or 1/8 inch straight bit and routed a groove on the end of the existing rabbet down to a depth of 13 millimeters or 1/2 inch. And this is the resulting profile. Next, I cut 45 degree miters on the three square pieces of wood, I used the mirror tile to mark the inside length on one of the pieces, added 1/8 of an inch, and then extended the line at 45 degrees to the outside. I lined up the pencil mark on the miter saw and set it in position with a stop block, which was one of the offcuts from earlier, and this was so that I could exactly repeat the length on the following three pieces. To add strength to the frame, I'm reinforcing the corners with loose tenons, which are made from strips of 6mm or 1/4 inch plywood. The mortises are cut into the ends of the wood on the router table with a 6mm or 1/4 inch straight bit, and to stop the mortises extending all the way to the edges, I've used 45 degree stop blocks made from offcuts. Once the tenon on one side is routed, then it's just a case of swapping over the stop blocks and routing the second side. The final thing that I needed to do before gluing up the frame was to cut out a notch for the LED power cable. Then I applied glue to the miters, mortises and loose tenons, stuck the four sides together, clamped the frame with a band clamp, and then checked it was square before leaving it to dry overnight. For the second frame section, I selected four pieces of pallet wood, which were similar in size. I ran them through the table saw to clean up one set of edges, and then once again to cut them all to the same width. I cut 45 degree miters on one side of each piece. One of those pieces was then cut to length with a miter on the opposite side, and I used the offcut as a stop block to cut the three remaining pieces to the same length. To mount it back into the frame, I routed a rabbet along one edge of the pieces, then I glued the miters and clamped the frame together with a band clamp, making sure it was square and that the distances between the corners were the same. Once the frame was dry, I reinforced the corners with dowels. To do that, I drilled holes at 45 degrees using a miter block of wood as a drilling guide and glued dowels into the holes. They were then cut flush with a pull saw and finished with sandpaper. The two frames were then glued together and clamped with as many clamps as I could find. Once the frame was dry, it was time to fit the LED tape, so I fitted it into the groove to find the correct length and then cut it to size. At this point, it's a good idea to test the LED strip with the controller and also to set the number of LEDs, which is done from the remote control. Then I removed the backing from the LED tape and stuck it down into the groove, and once again tested that the LED strip worked correctly. Next I fitted the mirror and a square of plywood, and they're held in place with glazier points, which are set with a screwdriver. The remote control works by infrared, so to make sure it can be seen by the receiver on the LED controller, I drilled a small hole through the front panel and then enlarged it at the back. The receiver then fits in the hole and the controller can be plugged into the LED strip. I screwed the controller down with self-tapping screws and plugged the power supply in. To mount the mirror on the wall, I'm going to use a French cleat. This is cut from a strip of plywood with a table saw set to 45 degrees. To give the French cleat something to attach to, I glued and screwed a piece of wood to the top of the frame. This was just cut from a length of pallet wood. I cut another square of plywood for the back. The French cleat was placed in position. I drilled some pilot holes, and then the French cleat was glued into position with some short temporary screws to hold it in place. I then turned it over and permanently screwed it in from the back. I plugged in the power cable to the controller and routed the wire through the corner, and then replaced the temporary screws with longer ones. Self-tapping screws were then used to secure the back to the rest of the frame. Finally, I screwed the opposite side of the French cleat to the wall, mounted the mirror, and switched it on. The remote control has options for the colours, effects and the speed, so that you can adjust the lighting to your taste. In the next video, I'm going to add a rechargeable battery to the mirror to make it portable. I'm going to replace the controller with an Arduino so that I can create some custom colour effects and also incorporate some other electronic modules, so watch out for that. Special mention to Storyblocks for sponsoring the video. Thanks Storyblocks, it really is very much appreciated. And do check out the 7-day trial, it's a great way to support the channel. If you enjoyed the video, then please give it a like and let me know in the comments below. And if you'd like to see more videos like this, then please subscribe. Also, click the bell to enable notifications. So thanks for watching, you have a fantastic week, and I'll see you again next time.